This is Andy Gutierrez from StarWars.com, and you are listening to Coffee with Kenobi with Dan Z. This is the podcast you're looking for.
I've been waiting for Celebration all year long.
Are you ready to celebrate?
Oh, and guess what? This is the podcast you're looking for.
This is James Arnold Taylor, and you're listening to Coffee with Kenobi. I have a good feeling about this.
Well, hello, friends, and welcome back to CWK Live. This is a special episode for the first week of June, last week of May. I'm your host, Dan Zare. So we'll be talking Star Wars with each and every one of you now. Monday, we couldn't do the show because we had Star Wars Celebration. I was just wrapping up and I was on an airplane. Tuesday, last night, just didn't work out. I want to get reacquainted with stuff with the family and, you know, kind of fill in the gaps. Mason had a baseball game. He did very well. They won, so that's great. Congratulations, Mason. Now, it's time to talk about Star Wars Celebration. So let's look at bringing in a guest. We're going to have a couple of guests tonight. First, let's bring in our first guest, who is not Corey Club.
Oh!
It's Tom Gross. Hello, Tom Gross.
Hello! It's so good to be here. I feel like I'm in a new room. This is a different room than normal.
It is.
Live.
Yeah, it's a live. You've never been on a live show with us.
No, I have not.
Facebook Live proper like this. So let's bring in our friends. Mary's here. Happy Kenobi Wednesday. Hello, Mary. Hope you're having a great time in California.
Hey.
Tyler is here. What's up, Tyler? He says, man, that new opening is sick. Well, thanks, brother. Jason is here. Hello, Jason. Good to have you. Hello, Ross. We just spent quite a bit of time with Ross at Star Wars Celebration, which we'll talk about. Mason is here. He says, hi, Tom, which is great.
Hello, Mason.
Minta can't make it tonight, but she'll tune in next week. No problem, Minta. We'll have it playing for you here in Instagram and on YouTube, of course. You'll be able to listen to it on the feed as well. Podcast. And Anthony is here. Hello, Anthony. We also got to hang out with Anthony, too. Jason says, hi, Tom. And so does Mary. How about that? Well, we're going to have another guest, too, coming on pretty soon. As soon as he is available. You can probably guess who it's going to be. So Mason says, Tom says, how, everyone?
Yeah. That's right. One-handed typing.
I love it. Well, hey, let's, Josh is here too. We also met Josh at Star Wars Celebration at the podcast meeting, which was great fun. We're going to talk about that because I didn't use my phone at all to take any pictures at the podcast meetup. So I need your pictures. So hopefully I'll be able to see some of those and get to see all the fun times we had because we had a great turnout. So let's go ahead and take a look at what is brewing in the world of Star Wars this week. Ooh. All right. So let's bring Tom back into the show. There he is.
Oh, hello, hello.
Hello, hello. So this week, David Nicely is here. Hello, David. It was good to see David as well. I'm going to show you some. I took a couple of pictures from some of our experiences overall. And we're going to go through. And Tom, we haven't looked at these really together before.
Ooh.
Luis, welcome. Luis is a tremendous series, Kenobi. Yes, it is. We will get to talking about Kenobi eventually. But for now, let's take a look at these. All right, so this is the first night. Tom, why don't you, so basically what happened was, Ross picked up Corey earlier in the day and they did some sightseeing and then Colby picked up Tom and then later me and we all went, to In-N-Out Burger and you recognize there and there is Monica, Ross's beloved there as well. Tell your story, Tom, about, what Colby had waiting for you.
Oh, yes. So I got off the plane, went and got my bag, was communicating with Colby all along. And so he pulled up outside the baggage claim and we put my suitcase in the back And I sat down inside the in the front seat, and there waiting for me was a coffee. Just what I wanted. And he and I, we went, because you were about 40 minutes later than we were, 30, 40 minutes later. So we went and parked in what's called the cell phone lot. I'm not sure what that means, but we went and parked in the, it's like a waiting spot, I suppose, for drivers. Anyway, and we drank, we each had a cup of coffee. We talked about the Colby cast. We talked about Coffee with Kenobi, all those, you know, wonderful things, and waited for you. So that was awesome. That was such a wonderful experience to hang out with Colby face to face for the first time. I felt like, you know, I've known Colby for a few years now, and but never met face to face. So that was awesome. And which was kind of actually the theme of this celebration, was seeing people face to face, either for the very first time or the first time in a very long time. So yeah, in and out. That was so good.
It was very good. And because of, apparently coffee is also kryptonite for you, you were able to stay awake till 3 a.m. because of the caffeine.
Oh yeah, that was wonderful. Yeah, that we finally got settled into our hotel room and had a hard time. I wanted to also mention that Ross gave me a present that he's been holding on to for a very long time. It was a Funko Pop of Xanathar, that is a Dungeons and Dragons character. So I much appreciated that. That was awesome. Thanks, Ross.
That was very fun. So every day we posted a picture in front of the Star Wars Celebration sign outside the Anaheim Convention Center. This is day one when the three of us were getting ready to rock and roll and headed to Star Wars Celebration for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
That was the first pair of Jordans that made its appearance at Star Wars Celebration.
Which, by the way, you got numerous comments on each day. So well done, sir,
yeah,
the Jordans.
That was great. So the second night, after Star Wars Celebration, was Disneyland After Dark Star Wars Night. And it was extremely a fantastic experience. We had, after the day guests had left, because you basically, when you walk in, you can see on a lot of our wrists, you've got a wristband that basically says you paid to be a part of the Star Wars Celebration, of Star Wars Disneyland After Dark Night. And we also had lanyards with instructions about different things, places to go, and it just also showed that you have permission to be there. So ultimately, when it came down to it, we rode everything we wanted to. Almost everything. It was everything. Like Indiana Jones, we walked right on. Haunted Mansion, we walked right on. Thunder Mountain Railroad, which we'll talk about, we walked right on. Rise of Resistance and Millennium Falcon, there was a bit of a wait, as with Star Tours, but it was Star Wars night, so you'd expect that. But it wasn't much of a wait at all. I mean, if you can go to Disneyland or Disney World for like a private event like that, it's the absolute way to go because it's reduced capacity, very, very easy. You can see here from left to right is Colby, Tom, me, Corey, Ross, and then Clayton Sandell. Wes wants to know, how often does Disney do Star Wars After Dark? Is that just during Celebration Anaheim? No, Wes, there's actually a couple of times. If you go to the Disney Parks blog or just type in Disneyland After Dark Star Wars Night, I think there were four dates in all. I don't know if this was the last one or not. I know the first one was on May the 4th. It was either I think there was a May the 3rd and a May the 4th one. But certainly check out the Disney Parks blog. And if you get a chance to do it, it's really, really worth it.
I was going to say that's a great question. And yeah, to reflect on what you said, definitely do it if you're interested, because it was fantastic.
And what do you want to say? Josh is actually checking for us right now. Thank you, Josh. Cool. Tom, what do you want to say about Disneyland, your experiences at Disneyland, as I scroll through some of these pictures?
Oh, my goodness. It was so, so wonderful. My first time ever being to Disneyland, and I haven't been to a Disney park since 1980, as you know, has been well documented on Coffee with Kenobi and Pour Over. So this was
everyone at Celebration that actually.
It was an announcement over the intercom. Yeah. So this was a very unique experience for me. It was absolutely wonderful. It is a magical place indeed. And what was a lot of fun was when you walk from one location in Disneyland to the next, I'm sure Disney World's the same way, it is a complete transition. You can, like when we left, I don't know, I think it was the Wild West area, and I don't remember what that's called. When we left there, yes. and we walked into it under a tunnel to the next spot. I could not hear anything that was going on behind me, only what was going on in front of me. So that was really neat. It's what a transition and what a skill to make that be able to happen. But just the sites, some of the famous sites like Main Street, Disneyland, to some of the new sites like Batu. I can't help but laugh at joy. I mean, that's what it all comes from. And just, it was so, so cool to walk into Batu and see, just what it looks like. And it felt like being in Star Wars to me. I mean, even with the crowds, I mean, it would have been really cool had everyone been dressed like, a rebel or someone who lives on Tatooine or Batu or something like that. But you know what? It didn't matter. First of all, there was tons of cosplay there to begin with. So it did kind of have that feel. But even so, even with the crowds, it was still just magical to be in that land. And like you said, Dan, we first went to Rise of the Resistance. And then I got to walk and see the Falcon, which was just insane. It was such an out-of-body experience. I was kind of stunned, to be honest with you. I found myself just, I sort of walked away from you guys and just sort of took in the sights all by myself. Mm-hmm. And all the people with lightsabers, and it was dusk, and the lightsabers are just shining in my eyes, and looking at the Falcon in its full grandeur of how Han Solo or Lando or Luke Skywalker would have seen it parked there. It was just, wow. I was speechless. I really was.
And I sent you the video, I think today, or maybe it was the other day, but I sent the video. Yeah. And you walked up and see it, and you were so happy. And I just, we just stepped back and let you savor that moment. And you turned around and you were happy, like deliriously happy. And you said, "What a piece of junk," but you couldn't even get it out. You were so excited. That was great.
I tried to be authentic, but it didn't quite work out that way.
No, I thought it worked out quite well, actually. So excellent. We had a wonderful time. The highlight for me, besides him seeing Batu for the first time, was a tie. No, it's not a tie. Rise of Resistance was pretty up there because you and Colby had never done it. Neither had Colby's children, because Colby's boys hung out with us, which was wonderful. But then on Thunder Mountain Railroad, you cackled and laughed so hard the whole time. That I think I may have almost wet myself from laughter because you're having so much fun. It was great. It was great fun.
I haven't had that much fun in a very long time. Yeah, when we started cranking up that first hill, it struck me. And I'm sorry, I apologize to everyone that was around me. I just could not stop laughing. There he is. Hey there.
Hello.
Hey.
He's here.
How's it going?
Good, good. Hey, I like your hat.
Hey, I like your hat.
Thank you. Corey Club is here. Tom. With us, everybody.
Yes.
Hey. How about it? How about it? All right, let's see if I can. Now I got to add your name on here, too. Let's see if I can figure this out.
Yes, indeed, sir. Looking nice in that hat.
Oh.
So, Corey, welcome back to the show. Okay. We were just talking about. Where'd he go? We were just talking about how. Tom was on Rise of Resistance and Thunder Mountain Railroad for the first time.
That was a highlight for me, just to be with Tom and his pure jubilation. He couldn't contain himself. It was quite the trip as far as your laughter was just, I think everybody on the whole ride was laughing along with you. For Thunder Mountain Railroad and just everything. That's the thing too. We kept looking at you, Tom, to see your expression, see what you're kind of your mood you're going through and stuff. Like you're just like a little kid. I loved it.
Oh, thanks. I appreciate that because I was absolutely having a ball. There was no two ways about it. And I just thought of this when we were on the Rise of Resistance. And Dan, maybe you're going to say something about this, but yeah. There's a spot where, and is it too soon for spoilers? Can I say what I want to say here?
About what?
There's Rise? A point where there's a bit of an excitement. There's an exciting moment in the ride towards the end. And we were just, it was a scream moment. And my arms went up in the air. I was like, yes! And then I reached over and I grabbed Dan and I just shook him. I shook him.
That's right.
It was hilarious.
I was afraid I was going to punch you in the ear, though. So I,
I wasn't
worried. I reached wide.
It was great. It was a blast.
Oh,
now,
man.
Now I gotta get you guys back.
Oh boy.
Oh, we're here. Don't worry, everybody. We're here.
They are here, ready to go.
Oh man. Hey, I was gonna while you're doing that, Dan, I was gonna toss out. Josh says, looks like they're done with Star Wars Nights this year. They have a grad night reunion at the end of June.
Oh, okay.
So thanks, Josh, for grabbing that information for us.
For sure.
Hi, Mary. I see your comment there. It's so good to see you at Celebration, too. I was glad to meet everybody at Celebration as they kind of came and went and saw the show. So that's what the best part is, too. I was talking to some coworkers about Celebration, and they kept telling me, oh, that conference, Star Wars conference thing you went to. I was like,
really?
I guess it was kind of like a conference. I mean, meet all your friends. I said that's part of it. Like, it's part of the con, and part of the excitement is meeting all my friends that we, you know, talk with on, you know, our Facebook pages and just online on social media and stuff. It's so amazing to be able to just meet people in person and go, oh, you're alive. You're real. So yeah. Pretty cool stuff.
Well, speaking of Dennis says, hey guys, just want to drop by and say hello. Great seeing you at Celebration. Dennis. It seems Absolutely. Like every time we're at Celebration, I never get to tell you goodbye because we always see each other and we just think we'll see each other next and we never do. It's like a tradition. Mm. So it's great to see you, buddy. We had a great time with you. We had a great time with everyone. Wes says, so you had never been on Star Tours then, Tom, which is true. You had never been on Star Tours.
No.
So we talked about Disneyland After Dark. We talked about the podcast meetup a little bit. Well, let's talk more about the podcast meetup.
Sure.
What are some of the highlights for you? And please, and everyone, send pictures because I haven't seen any pictures of the podcast meetup.
Well, one of the highlights for me for the podcast meetup was Frank and his wife had printed out. So if you've been to Celebration, each stage has its own logo. And is it 2019?
Yeah.
I was asked to do the podcast stage logo to design that. And now my head is crooked. And it's live. And it's weird. Okay, that's all right. It was really weird. Here we go. We'll do this. No, that's not as cool.
It was fun.
This is a horrible moment. There.
This is like
I love live,
better.
Buddy. This is like our
This is great. No, but you get to do the podcast stage logo I did in 2019, and it was a great piece of artwork. And in doing that, Frank and his wife had printed out a copy of it and wanted us to, all three of us to sign it. I think that was the coolest thing. I was floored the fact that like they had printed out and they were going to do that and make that happen. And so, it was a cool moment for me and I got a picture of it. I always tell my kids, they always ask, do you sign everything, Dad? I was like, sometimes. Yeah. So got that memory locked away and then I showed the kids and they were all thought I was the coolest dad ever. So pretty cool.
Duh. Mason says it's poor Duh. Over all over again. That's right. It is. One of the highlights for me was when we started. Oh, just seeing everyone was great.
Yes.
You know, getting to meet Anthony in person for the first time. Craig Dickinson was there. We had met him earlier in the day. It was just so many great people. Megan was there. The Daft Prawns were there. Greg was there from Rebel Base Card. We just had a wonderful bevy of people there. Lou and Becky were there. And the trick for this one was that the Obi-Wan Kenobi premiere was at the exact same time. But we all skipped out on that so we could meet our people. And I wouldn't change a thing because I thought it was a blast. But early on, Jeff McGee had said to me he was going to put a golden Burger King crown on my head so he could find me in the crowd because I like to work the room, as they say.
Yes, yes. I think a highlight for me was, of course, seeing everybody. I mean, that's what it's all about, is getting together with everybody. But the one person that I wasn't expecting to see that was such a pleasure to meet was Daz Davies and his friend.
That was so
cool. And it was such, I remember I was walking back. Corey, you were with me, right? We were walking back from the bar to where people were kind of collecting and gathering. And I look to my left and I get a little tiny wave from someone sitting at a table. And I held the eye contact for just long enough to be like, I think I should know who that is. And so I went back and introduced myself, and Daz Davies. I was like, oh my gosh, how fun. Yep. And so we stood and talked with them for a little bit. And then I ran into them on the last day, just sort of the final hours of the show for me on Saturday night. And it was great just kind of having that second conversation and just sort of wrapping things up. And it was so nice, because they flew a long way get to California. So Daz Davies, it was so great to meet you at the podcast hangout.
It was wonderful to meet Daz Davies. He was very kind, very gracious. And then we saw him later on the podcast stage as well. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about, because we were very ambitious. The first day we released day one, we did a before we went to the convention, and then at night when we were half asleep because we were so tired. We didn't record on Friday because we went to Disneyland, and it was a really late night because Disneyland closed at 1 o'clock. And then Saturday was a much different day, as was Sunday. So we didn't do a celebration days 2, 3, and 4. So that's basically what we're doing now.
Yeah.
I guess we should talk about, we talked about Disneyland, but what about on Friday? Were there any particular highlights for all of you? And in fact, I'll start with this. Friday, Thursday I had an author signing with Amy Rakow, which was wonderful. I had my mythology panel, which we talked about before, which is really great. And a half hour before I even went on, they closed the doors because they already full to capacity, which is a wonderful surprise. It was really nice. But Saturday, I was pretty much landlocked on the fan stage, which was great. I had the most panels to introduce. I met a lot of great people there and just had an absolute ball. But I was able to sneak out a couple times and join you guys on the show floor. That's when we first saw Lou Mangiello and Becky Mankin there as well. Craig says, apotheosis, baby. That's right. Mythology thing. Dennis says, he can't believe you brought the Star Wars book for me to sign, and never managed to get him to sign it. Oh, man. Well, Dennis, either next time or just mail it to me, buddy, and I'll sign it for you. Happy to do that. Dennis also said the podcast meetup was crazy. It was hard to get through a conversation before more people showed up. You had to interrupt one discussion to say hi to someone else. So many great people were there. It was an absolute blast. All right, guys, tell me your highlights from Friday.
Let's see, Friday. So yeah, I really enjoyed doing the Lucasfilm, or it was the Galaxy's Edge like product panel. They walked through a lot of the updates for Galaxy's Edge merchandise. It's cool to hear from those folks that were just super excited about that kind of stuff. And I know every the hits just kept on coming. Like, they kept revealing new things after new things after new things. And it was so cool to be like, wait, what? Oh. Just because all the things they've kind of introduced in Galaxy's Edge, they're looking to refresh some things, add some new things. I know they're going to refresh the lightsaber builds. So that was cool to see all that stuff come out, because we're excited to go back to Galaxy's Edge eventually as a family and do that. My kids are excited for that. What else? Oh, the Tom and I attended the gaming panel for
Asmodee.
Yes, thank you. And that was cool because we had played a little previously, a tabletop game, short, brief introduction to it. But then this was kind of like some of the reveals they had, and that room was excited, man, for board games, and it was packed. They were we got in towards the end, and then they were trickling people in. So it's cool to see people's excitement for that category of gaming and that fandom there. So I'm excited about that. I told my kids about that, and we might try to figure out how to pick one of those games up and check it out.
Oh, it was magnificent. And there, if there's a special passion among Star Wars fans, the gaming folks are it. Closely, if not closely, right around, probably as passionate about what they do as the cosplayers. But man, those gaming folks, boy, you're right, Corey, when they made those reveals, especially the one I was particularly excited about was in the game Legion, when they announced that they were going to bring Ewoks to the game.
Yeah. Oh, cool.
That was phenomenal. So yeah, I like that one. The one, so my highlight on Friday, boy, there's so many. Friday was really quite the day.
While you're saying that, I'm going to share something pretty fun, but go ahead.
Oh yeah. So probably the one that I was pleasantly surprised, the highlight that I wasn't expecting to have that was just magnificent was the Light and Magic panel, where they talked about the 6-piece documentary written by Lawrence Kasdan, or directed by Lawrence Kasdan, about the history of ILM. It was filled with so many stories about ILM, so many stories about George Lucas that I'd never heard before. They gave us little clips, so previews of what to expect in the documentary that was, filled with just a lot of really cool information about the history of it. My favorite part was at the very end, they asked Lawrence Kasdan, what was your mission in doing this? And he said, besides giving the history of ILM and giving the credit to all these people who deserve credit, you know, they're on the credits, but they haven't ever been given the credit. And so this was kind of that tip of the hat to all those people behind the scenes. But he said another goal that he really wanted was to give a new generation of risk takers and people who love that part of the business some inspiration, something to shoot for, that knowledge that you share information, you don't keep it to yourself, and you take risks, you don't stand back and let others take it for you. So it was really cool. It was somewhat moving at times, and just a lot of fun to hear all those people share the stories.
So speaking of fun, we're getting a lot of great comments from people. Craig says, does anyone else need to refer back to the schedule when telling people about the trip? It all bleeds together in its awesomeness.
Yes.
It kind of does. It helped me that I had certain things I had to do on certain days, but I can see, because when you think about the different panels themselves, they do kind of blend together a little bit. So look, here is the vote. The Disney Parks blog did this, I think, last year or the year before. They already announced they're going to sell the Obi-Wan Kenobi from Episode 3 and Obi-Wan Kenobi lightsaber, legacy lightsaber, and Qui-Gon Jinn's as well. Actually, I had to leave that panel a little bit early, the Disney Parks blog merchandise panel, because I had to run and do some stuff for my fan stage. But Corey was kind enough to take a lot of pictures for me and send them over. And as he was texting me and I was running to my panels, I was like, oh my gosh, I just wanted to stop and sit on the floor and look at these. But one of the things to announce is for Doc Ondar's collection, you've got 6 lightsaber hilts to choose from. They're going to be at Doc Ondar's. You've got Jocasta Nu, the librarian of the Jedi Order. So that's what Tom's going to vote for probably.
Oh yeah.
From Attack of the Clones. Ooh. Quinlan Vos from the Clone Wars. Depa Balaba from the Bad Batch. And also she is the Jedi Master to the right, Padawan Caleb Dune, which is Kanan Jarrus, by the way. Let's just be honest. That's the only one you're allowed to vote for. I've got to have a Kanan Jarrus legacy lightsaber. It's the coolest. Right? I voted for last time, too. Sifo Dyas from Clone Wars, cool. And Padawan Barriss Offee from Attack of the Clones. So, guys, in all honesty, which one do you think you'll vote for?
Oh, I'm with you, Dan. Kanan Jarrus all the way. I love that one.
I mean, look how cool it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now how is this one different than his, like, what else, Kanan Jarrus one?
It's
right?
The same. It's the same.
Okay. That's what I thought.
But because Bad Batch is more recent, my theory is that that's why they put that on there.
Oh.
That makes sense to me. I don't have that confirmed, but that just makes sense.
And he was a young Padawan in that too. So
right. So yep. Kanan and Dennis say Kanan, so they are correct. Good job, guys. You moved to the front of the class.
Correct. Gold star.
Yes.
Yeah. Of course, I want to vote for Jocasta Nu, but man, that Caleb Dune one is just so cool. I would vote for the Caleb Dune one for sure.
Yeah. Okay. Good. You can stay on the show. That's good news. Let's be honest. They're all great.
Good, good.
They're all fantastic.
They are
all great. Yeah. Absolutely.
Mary says she loves Quinlan, but the canon is awesome. Ooh, I'm optimistic. Last time, it was Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. The Jedi from Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order, his was the one that was selected. Not his name is suddenly escaping me. I can picture him perfectly. Who was it? Everyone's going to jump in now and say who it is. Mason says Sifo Dyas or Kanan. Those are good choices, Mace. Jason says Kane is one of his top three favorite Jedi, so we'd vote for him. Great.
Yeah.
I like good call. Jason. Cal Kestis, of course. Ah, it's the tip of my tongue. Cal Kestis, he'll be bringing that to the riverfront for the signing. All right. That's right. Well, I will definitely see you there. Oh, it looks like my camera froze. Speaking of the signing, right. That is Saturday, June 18th from 4:30 to 5. The book talk and author signing followed by a Q&A, and then we're going to be watching Star Wars, A New Hope. So you can't really go wrong with
cool.
That.
Oh, cool. Big screen.
Fun.
Let's see if I can unfreeze my camera here. I am frozen solid, ladies and gentlemen.
Carbonite.
Okay, I think I'm back. I think I'm back. Good deal. All right, so what are some other highlights, guys? I guess we don't have to go day by day. Totally up to you on that one.
Gosh, I agree with Craig. I have to go back and look at my my list of celebration stuff.
Well,
let's
Tom,
see.
While he's doing that, Tom, why don't you talk sure. about your experiences with the Mandalorian panel?
Mm.
Oh, man. So I was in the what was the stage up on the third floor? It's the only time I got up there. Whatever stage that was. The which one?
Was it the Twin Sun stage or was it the Galaxy stage?
Galaxy stage, that's what it was. So I was in the Galaxy stage for the Mando Plus. I didn't realize how important that plus was going to be when going to that, but there were lots of things. It was really cool. Those of you who are there, make sure you fill in the cracks that I'm going to skip over. But it started with Dave Filoni and Favreau on the stage with the moderator, and they talked a little bit. And then they brought out, of course, Pedro Pascal came out, and the place went insane. Just to see him, he was so speechless. He didn't know what else. He didn't really know what to say. I felt like, but you know, he's just so cool. And he's cool Star Wars, you know? And so he came out and shared a little bit. They brought out his trainer and his stunt person, who I didn't realize was John Wayne's grandson.
Yeah.
Which I thought was super cool. And he had a cowboy hat. And when he walked over to Filoni, they both sort of did their, the doffing of the hats, which was really fun. I'm going to miss some people here going down the panel, so fill it in the comments. But on that stage were, you had Giancarlo Espinosa, Emily Swallow, the armorer, Carl Weathers came out, and then you had Tamora Morrison, who, when he came out, was electric. I mean, he was probably one of the most consistently electric people throughout the entire celebration. But he came out and he did the New Zealand dance. I forget what they call that. But he did that tribal dance out in front, which just was wonderful. It was just magnificent to see him do that. Had a great time. Let's see. And then Rosario Dawson came out. Did I already say her? Then we had Katie Sackhoff on the stage. And then there was one seat left. Before I get to that, they talked, obviously, everybody talked about their own character, their experiences in recording in the volume. They talked about the show itself and the meaning and some of the meaningful parts of the show to them. And so then they showed us a trailer. Now, you all that were at the Thursday Lucasfilm panel in the morning got to see a trailer for The Mandalorian, but we got more in the Mandalorian Plus session. So we got an extra about 20 seconds, I think they said. And I don't know where it was new because I wasn't in Thursday's morning's session. So I don't know what we saw that you didn't. But that was electric watching that, and the hairs on my arms rose as I continued to see things on that screen. And right now, as I talk about it, I get that. But then Dave Filoni looks down. He goes, "We have one more. There's one more seat. Who's supposed to be down there?" And then they brought up the Ahsoka logo across the screen. And again, we all went crazy. And so they talked a little bit about how they've only been filming for 3 weeks, how well it'd been going, all of that. And then they teased, well, we might have something to show you. And then boom, everybody went crazy. Yeah. And so after three, and Dave said, the cast talked about it and they wanted to get certain things in there. So they cut some things specifically for the trailer. And they showed us about a 30-second trailer for Ahsoka. The two big reveals. So am I good to give the two big reveals? Is it too soon?
I think you can.
May
say
I?
It's all over social media. You can say it.
That's what I thought. Okay. So in the trailer, of course, we see Ahsoka. But the first reveal is she's walking onto a ship, and you see it. Laku, right, of Hera. And so we see Hera walking onto the ship.
Messing with this broadcast because now you're breaking up.
Oh no! Am I back?
We heard you. You're back. We heard you. You're back. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. And so we get the reveal that Hera will be in this live action, and then the big one. And I be honest with you guys, I don't remember how she was introduced in the trailer. But we get the reveal of a live action Sabine. Sabine Wren was on the screen. And so again, you know, how many times can an audience just go insane, and how does it continue to get bigger and bigger? But it did. And then what was cool is then at the conclusion of the trailer, you get the Ahsoka logo again, but then it faded. The lights did not come up. And then we get an image that comes up behind, and it is the tapestry of the rebels that we see at the end of the animated show. And Sabine's hand goes up and touches Ezra.
People lost it, bro. I lost their mind.
Oh man.
I sure did.
Tremendous.
That's
Filoni goes,
crazy.
Well, it is Disney or Mando Plus. And so the actress that plays Sabine came out and spoke a little bit. She's a marvelous person. But I apologize. I cannot remember her name to save myself right now in the moment.
I'm actually not sure.
Oh, the voice actress?
No, the
actress who's going to play. Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. I don't even know. I didn't.
Someone can Google it for us. That would be great.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was tremendous. And I guess the Bad Batch on Sunday, all these panels. I went to the first one, the Lucasfilm one, but the others I wasn't able to go to because I had responsibilities as host of my own. But it was great to hear you guys talk about it and share it with me and with all of us online in the CWK Cafe. It seemed wonderful. You can hear the cheers like around the convention center. It's so exciting. The buzz was so good. And what people have to understand about Celebration is it really is unlike anything else. I mean, there's constantly things going on. There's plenty of room. I think the Anaheim Convention Center is a perfect venue for this because it's very big. There's a lot of room, but it's also fairly easy once you get the lay of the land to make your way around because you just basically have these huge escalators that you use to get up and down to the second or third floor. Mm-hmm. And then you can just run down to the main area as well. And there's also plenty of food areas, too, places to get drinks, plenty of restrooms all over the place, and nothing but Star Wars as far as the eye can see for miles and miles and miles around.
Yeah, one thing I wanted to say too about the whole convention itself. We talked about this on the first day, I think, a little bit, the way it was spread out, and the convention floor was really kind of set up to where it was almost like you kind of tiered up from, you know, the vendors to the showroom to the Star Wars stage, and then you had the autograph hall, and you know, they had some other like photo booths and things like that we had done, but it was cool to see that was kind of spread out that much. I was like, it made my anxiety go down a little bit.
Sure.
So I appreciated that. Yes. And I know what we talked about too, just because that Star Wars stage sometimes gets so loud and so crazy that you can't, you know, you're like, well, what's going on over there? And we talked about that even before we left. It was the fact that like there's a lot going on in that stage, and there was, but it was just kind of its own little island or something like that. So it was nice to be able to have that separated the way they put together.
I agree with that. And thank you for looking up the name, Corey. It is Natasha Lou Bordizzo. I'm not sure the correct pronunciation, so I apologize for that. Tyler says, you guys did a great job covering over the weekend. I lived it through you. Well, thank you, Tyler. I'm really grateful that you felt that way. Wes says, big near Disneyland, great weather, couldn't ask for a better con. I agree with that. And you know what? I thought the weather was perfect. It was like 70s and a nice breeze. And it was just so good. Beautiful. There's one big thing. I know you guys had to go home early before the con was over. The last day on Sunday, one of the things I did was I went to the Mandalorian experience. Now, did you guys see the pictures in the Instagram on Coffee?
Yeah.
All right. So when I saw people after that and I said, hey, did you see it? If they told me no, then I said, oh, it's terrible. It stunk. Because I don't want them to feel bad. Because it was insane. It was absolutely insane. So the way it works out, you walk into this room and the first thing you see on your left is R2-D2. The one used in The Mandalorian and the Book of Boba Fett. You look to the right, there's Queel. And then straight ahead, in all his splendor, like I got choked up several times on this thing, was the Mandalorian Din Djarin, and you know, fully right there. I mean, everything in this area was actually used on all the Disney Plus shows. Actually screen used stuff. And it's just you're just looking at it. And it takes your breath away. It's museum quality. They had the head of the Rancor from the Book of Boba Fett. They had the Naboo N1 Starfighter with Grogu inside it, moving around animatronic-wise, making noises, waving at you. Got choked up at that. They had Boba Fett's throne. They had pretty much all the costumes you could imagine. They had Ahsoka. They had the Darksaber. They had all of Din Djarin's weapons. They had a fully animatronic Bantha. Got my picture by that. They had everything. It was just unbelievable. I got choked up so many times. I hope they do like a traveling exhibit of it at some point. They had the mythology of Star Wars one back in the late 90s. That was a touring museum exhibit. And that's the closest thing I can think of to that. I hope people got to see it. If not, I hope the pictures I posted were able to give you some sort of sense of being there, because it's really tremendous.
Yeah, you know, we walked past that sign and we talked about it a little bit, like, hey, we should go try and see that, because it really wasn't like promoted, from what I remember, within like the program. Yeah, so it's like, but then you had to get tickets or something into it. Was that right? It was like a sneak peek or something to that end. And I know we talked about, we'll get to it when we get to it. And I know that we should have done it earlier, but I wish you just didn't know, really. And well, then I see all the wonderful pictures.
Like a lightning lane kind of situation and get reservations.
Okay.
It was very, very popular. So it's not like you just walk right in.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tom, you didn't see it, did you?
No, that's probably, you know, it's funny because we talked about before this celebration, at least I did with my experience in Chicago, saying, hey, what you don't see, you don't see. And, you know, there's so much else to do and see. It's okay. That's the one thing, man. I wish I could have gotten in there now, seeing all the pictures. And was the N1 Starfighter, did you say that N1 Starfighter was in there as well?
Yep, it was
like full size?
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, man. That's so, yeah. If there are regrets, that's it. Probably. Probably too crowded and wasn't organized well, probably. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. But the opposite. Yeah.
But the opposite.
As you're walking out, they had two more costumes. On the left, they had the character Paz Vizsla. I believe it's Paz Vizsla that Jon Favreau's voices. And then on the right, they had the Trapper Wolf X-Wing costume of Dave Filoni. So that was kind of perfect.
Oh, nice.
Craig says he couldn't get the reservation, but he did standby to get in and was recommended this by Anthony King. So see, CWK Alliance working together.
Ah, yes.
Working together.
Well done.
So good. Well, guys, any last minute highlights about Star Wars Celebration? Like, and this is the first time also that on the way home, I didn't record on the way home from the airport because I frankly was just pretty wiped out. I was really tired. and I knew I'd be able to break it down to you guys. This is kind of a double dip because it's the live show for the week, but it's also a chance for us to record the show we didn't get a chance to record at Celebration, where we just talk about Celebration. I mean, really the thing for me truly was getting to spend time with so many of you, hanging out with all of you, getting to see people you haven't seen before. On Saturday night, we went to downtown Disney, and a whole bunch of us, people that we mentioned, you know, Craig, Dennis and his family, who else was there? Ross was there. My brother-in-law.
Smooth Rivera and his wife.
Greg was there. Both Gregs were there.
Yeah.
Ion Cannon and Greg McLaughlin.
Smooth Rivera, Dan Lowe.
His wife, Daniel Lowe. Mary.
Colby.
And her son, Chaz. Colby was there with one of his older son. I think that's everybody. We had everybody was welcome. It was just hard to kind of find everybody. Craig sat across from me, and he and Chaz got the biggest ice cream in the history of mankind.
Oh my gosh!
It was pretty funny.
I'll put a picture of it in the cafe.
Yeah, do. But we had actually, I think I can do it now. We had this the best time. Dennis, speaking
it
of
was
Saturday,
great.
Thank you to everyone for being so kind to my wife and boys. It meant the world to me. Well, of course, my friend. It meant the world to us to be able to see them and meet them and hang out with them. That was just so much fun.
Part of the family.
Yeah. Yep. Tom, would you want to say anything about that night?
Yeah. I mean, I sat there and looked down the table and I just was like, this is an absolutely amazing, I don't know if phenomenon might be a strong word, but it was just so great to look down the table at all of our friends and just see everyone together laughing, having a good time, talking Star Wars, talking Celebration. And even, you know, I heard several conversations about just our lives in general, which is great. You know, sometimes we can have enough Star Wars and it's good to turn and talk about each other and the things that we love, like family and our jobs and stuff like that. So that was super cool to witness all of that. And then it just worked out to where
I saw the ice cream.
Look at that.
Let me try to, I got to shrink this down so we can see Craig's face. There's Mary and Chaz with the big ice cream.
Oh my goodness.
And then here's Craig. You got to see Craig's face here because it's just, he's just like a happy little kid, man.
That's good. Oh man.
There we go.
Oh. Yeah, that's right, Mary. We talked books and stuff. You're right.
So look at Craig's face. Whoops. He was so happy.
Attaboy.
Oh, yeah.
He's like, yep. Wow.
Tyler says that I look sinful. I want one. Craig says that's a $14 shake. No wonder you made that. It's $14.
Oh, wow.
I tasted that. Like that too. It was good.
Oh my goodness.
I was sorry to miss that. I saw that you guys had gone down and sorry and done that. So I was really bummed out that I was able to miss it. But you know, that's okay. I'm glad it was cool to see you guys celebrate that way and just enjoy each other's time and it was a blast. Sure,
there's always the next time.
Absolutely. It will come around again.
So speaking of at the end of this it was announced that Star Wars Celebration is going to be in London, April, I think, 7th to 10th. I think that's right. I'll pull it up on my
sounds right
phone here, but I think that's what
data
I wrote
pad.
Down. 7 to 10. Anybody confirm that? I took a picture. Let's see. I got a lot of silly pictures here. Yep, April 7 to 10. That's exactly right. At the Excel Center, which I guess is about an hour from London, the convention center itself. Lee says, how rich. Yes, that ice cream was probably very rich. And it is Easter weekend, so that's a problem. So it's tricky, right? It's during Easter weekend. It's less than a year after the last celebration. So it is actually during our spring break, Tom. Most of it is. So I don't know. What are you guys thinking? Where are you leaning towards Celebration London?
Wow, I've never been overseas. It's a chance to experience that. I don't know. I'm not opposed to it, but again, it's a big jump, literally, across the pond.
Well, another valid, Jeff McGee had said, if I'm going to go to London, I'm not going to spend 4 days in a convention center, which is valid. So you'd have to think about, you know, going and staying before or staying after and doing some sightseeing.
I would love to take an extra week and just explore. I mean, I don't know. I mean, another thing too is I'd love to take my wife and do that. And, you know, a lot of things to juggle there. So, we'll see.
A lot of things to think about. Ross has run a big Airbnb locally for CWK House for a bunch of us. It's actually not a terrible
Ross.
Idea.
That's
not
a terrible idea at all.
That's not a bad idea.
Oh, thank you for the ideas.
I love that idea.
Pretty good. Pretty good stuff. Well, guys, thank you both so much for joining us. Thank you for making my celebration so special. I mean, all of our friends there, it was just great. But being able to share it with you two as my travel companions and longtime friends of not only the show, but just of me and my family. We had so much fun. We're going to record a pour-over later talking about kind of the behind-the-scenes shenanigans and goofiness and silliness as the three of us experience when we're together, which is usually pretty crazy. Mason says, Dad, check your text. All right, Dad is checking his text. Oh, no way.
What?
Apparently there was a raccoon that's sneaking around. Cool. Well, how about that?
No going wonder. Looking for a well going for after night. Yep.
That's
dip.
Nice. Okay. Well, that helps to plan things around. Anyway, so guys, again, thank you for everything. It was just a blast sharing it with you. This is where you talk back, or you know, are your mic still working?
Oh. Okay. Yes, the next is still working. I thought you were exiting the conversation. Wow. I agree with you. I think this celebration was well worth it.
My camera froze again.
No, it's interesting because we kind of debated about Celebration Chicago, Celebration Orlando, kind of putting those together, like what do they rank? You know, this one was definitely up there. I think it's a long time coming. Definitely, again, like I said, to hang out with everybody. That was the biggest highlight for me, was seeing all my friends and seeing everybody in person and just hanging out and enjoying just the conversation and the friendship and just having laughs and just having a blast. I mean, like you said, it's just that's what it's all about, the community of our friends of the show, and just Star Wars in general was just the best thing. So I don't know. Let's top it next time, right?
There you go. Louis says, thanks, guys, for sharing your experiences. Absolutely. Tom, any last-minute thoughts for you?
No. Seeing everybody was just a joy. That was awesome. Thanks to all for coming and hanging out with us, for sure.
And thank all of you for joining us here tonight on a special CWK Live as Tom and Corey do the dance. Oh, he's doing the scarecrow dance. We are going to record later tonight a review of Obi-Wan Kenobi episodes 1 and 2. We know episode or chapter 3 or part 3 dropped today. We will get to that one later. We got to catch up first. But again, thanks everybody for joining us. On behalf of myself, Tom Gross, and Corey Club, if you like the banter and you like the three of us together, then you can certainly become a member of the CWK Alliance. That is where you can go and support Coffee with Kenobi. You get something out of it as well. You get an exclusive weekly audio and video podcast where we talk about Star Wars, pop culture, all kinds of great stuff. We will see you next Monday at our normal time for Facebook Live, where the topic is going to be the top 5 moments from part 3 of Obi-Wan Kenobi. I know we didn't do a part 1 and 2 top 5. We'll try to figure that out at some point. We're just going to focus on part 3 of Obi-Wan Kenobi next Monday night. So be sure to get your top 5 list ready and join us. All right, everybody. See you next time. Enjoy the rest of your week. Be good.
This podcast is not endorsed by the Walt Disney Company or Lucasfilm Limited. It is intended for entertainment and informational purposes only. The official Star Wars website can be found at www.starwars.com. Star Wars, all names, sounds, and any other Star Wars related items are registered trademarks and or copyrights of Disney and their respective trademark and copyright holders. All original content of this podcast is the intellectual property of Coffee with Kenobi unless otherwise indicated.
This is the podcast you're looking for.